What's going on, everybody? Real quick before we jump into this gameplay, one of the reasons why I haven't been uploading is because I'm working really hard with a good friend of mine, Aiden. We're working on a series coming up soon. Gonna add another series to the channel in NCAA football. So if you're interested in that, make sure you stay tuned in the upcoming days. We're gonna try to get that out there for you. So in this episode, we're gonna make some more progress in year three. A very tough schedule to begin this year, as you guys will see some of the teams we had to play at the early stages of this season, including these formidable opponent Milwaukee Bucks, who actually finished number one in the East last year. So a very tough schedule with a lot of up and downs. I'm going to try to go over all of them here in this episode, so buckle up and stay tuned. And look at this right here, coming across the middle, picking off that pass like a wide receiver, running a slant across the middle. I take it hard against Bledsoe, and not a very favorable rim there. I got robbed on the end one, but I still step up and hit two free throws, giving me 6 points on the game so far. My matchup, Eric Bledsoe, is not going to be an easy one, as he is one of the better defensive guards in the league right now, as I get a jump shot to fall. Not just him, though. There's plenty of defensive weapons on this Milwaukee team. It's why it's so hard to get a win against them. But so far, we're hanging tough. It's tied up at 39, and I take Chris Middleton off the dribble. But just as I was talking about, that defense of Milwaukee is just so tough. We find ourselves on a bit of a run here in the third quarter. And with that said, we're trying to keep our foot on the pedal. As you can see, great defense so far in the second half. No points for Milwaukee for the first five and some change minutes of the second half. They finally get a bucket to go, but on the very next possession after that, great team defense on DiVincenzo inside. And we're running a break as a 3-on-1. Kately's had some ups, he's had some downs, but he puts that one down. My college teammate, Aaron Kately, he's had a pretty interesting beginning to his NBA career. I'll definitely be discussing him more as the games go on. Nice block by AD, putting Dellen's right layup off the back of the backboard. And that's a pass that, for some reason, in 2K20, I just can't make anymore, despite having almost maxed out passing skills. And unfortunately, that turnover kind of led to a Milwaukee run now. You guys already know, in every game that we seem to have a lead early on, it just seems to dissipate over time. We just can't continue to hold on to leads. But look at this. Maybe trying to switch the momentum back towards us as I do a great job manipulating that pick and roll. George Hill over contested. And that's a tough layup, but an and one for me, as I was mad about the layup against Bledsoe earlier on in the game just rimming out. But this one, got a little better luck on my side. George Hill tries to come back at me. No good. Me and him, we're kind of exchanging blows, going back and forth a little bit. I attack him again. I want to leave him in the dust, but he comes out of nowhere and sends that back. Me and George Hill exchanging punches, exchanging blows right now so far in this game. This third quarter has been all between me and him, as I get a nice screen and Anthony Davis with his second reverse lob of the game. We've talked about Kately having some up and downs, us as a team being a little inconsistent, but to be honest, Anthony Davis, he's been a little up and down here in year three too. But in this episode, he's starting to get it going again, as you guys will see. But look at this, my teammate Jahlil Okafor getting double teamed in the paint. I talked a little bit about my confidence going up as a shooter, and there's another one dropping for me, as I'm not hesitating anymore when it comes to taking outside shots. We're up by six here within the fourth. I got Bledsoe on me one-on-one. Look at this jab I give him. Spin jump shot. I had him stumbling a little bit there too. We're going to take a second look at that, as this was probably my favorite highlight of this game. Milwaukee has a plethora of defensive weapons to throw at you, so it's always a good feeling whenever you get a play like that to happen. Now the lead is six, and I don't know what Rashawn Holmes was doing. I know he really shouldn't be on Chris Middleton in the first place, but at the same token, it's plays like that that really give us that calling card of our team. That's, oh, we seem to always let the team get back into it, because it seems like that's always what happens. We build a nice lead, and when it comes down to crunch time, we just become a whole different squad. We don't retain any of the positives that we've been doing throughout the game. But just like that, interrupting me is Anthony Davis pulling up from deep in the corner. So lead is now to two. I try it again from mid-range. This time it's no good. And here comes Giannis. We got to stop the ball. We got to stop Giannis. We can't let him get in the paint. But somehow, someway, Kately lets Chris Middleton go back door. And one of the reasons why Milwaukee is still staying around is Aaron Kately, as he's had his fair share of struggles this game. And that play right there further cements that. And look at Giannis sending back AD. It's tied up at 100 now after two free throws from Milwaukee. Trying to take the lead. I try to step in and force Bledsoe into a charge, but my efforts were in vain. And as you can see at the bottom of your screen, 13-3 run for Milwaukee. Every single game we have a lead, especially against good teams. This is what seems to happen, but AD doesn't want to give up. Second chance points tying the game back up. Here comes Giannis dunking over our defense on the very next time up the floor. Josh Hart trying his best to limit the Greek freak, but his efforts are in vain. We luck out though. Giannis misses the free throw to make it a three-point game. Here comes Josh Hart attacking the defense immediately right after. Gets forced into a bad shot, however, trying to do too much, as sometimes Hart can get, you know, like many young guards, he seems to sometimes do too much. And trying to overcontest on Giannis. Easy backdoor cut for him. It seems like this is our last chance. Back against the wall. Four-point game. Kaylee trying to cut into this deficit. But unfortunately, that shot would be off the mark. And of course, Giannis is just so gifted athletically. And it looks like that will be the nail in the coffin right there. It was that 360 lob to Giannis. Josh Hart, last chance today. Rims out. I try again. Just another desperation shot. And I actually get my second three to go. It's not often you see me make more than one three in a game, but unfortunately, it'd be just too little too late. And I'll end my second game of my third year in the NBA with 23-7 and 8-4 steals. Mirotić was great off the bench, 22. That's very key for us right now. We always need our bench stepping up just for the fact that we've lost some guys like Torrey Craig. He signed to Charlotte. We're just not as deep as we were last year, so we need guys stepping up off the bench, as you saw. Also, Aaron Kately, 4 of 12. He had a solid start to his NBA career against Atlanta, but this game he just didn't have it. And of course, Giannis with over 40 points. That always doesn't help, but what can you do against them? And we're going to switch our focus to the next game of our season. Our schedule kind of eased up after having to take on Atlanta and Milwaukee. So we won two easy games, back to 500, and now we got to take on the freshly crowned champion, Los Angeles Lakers. Of course, led by Faron, LeBron, Kuzma. So many guys on this team that can just beat you in so many ways. And they're a lot like Milwaukee in the sense that they're great defensively. All the star-studded defensive players they have, especially at the guard position. So it's never easy for me going up against these guys. But off to a solid start is your Pelicans. We're known for two things. One, giving up leads, and two, starting off games a little slow. But if we can come out and play this type of intense ball game against the Lakers as another shot's rejected by AD, then there's nobody that we can't step up against, right? And look at this quick pass over to Anthony Davis. I had a assist to Kaylee in the corner to begin the game, and now I got one to Anthony Davis cutting. But if you guys know anything about me and my friends, it wouldn't be long till they try to get me back and get one up on me. Faron splashing a three on the early goings of this game, and the Lakers going on a bit of a run. They're taking the lead, and they're up four now. Coming off a double screen, manipulate it well. And now I got Austin Rivers on me. Got him stumbling. Another ankle breaker victim here in the early portions of year three. Lakers, they acquired Austin Rivers in the offseason to help with the departure of Avery Bradley. But I don't know if a guy like him can check me. So they put Lonzo back on me. And now here comes Anthony Davis. He surprisingly had some struggles. He hasn't packed that same punch this year like he did in the playoffs. But speaking of punches, he punched that one down, and maybe he can start getting it going. We can see playoff AD back for a little bit. Here comes Faron, another block. AD, strong down low this game, as the unibrow is really leading us on both sides of the floor. Especially in this game, and you guys will see at the break just how in control, just how much of a career night this has been so far for AD. But before we get to that, we got to try to close out Los Angeles, try to maintain this lead before the break, as there's Faron getting another basket to fall. Kick out to the corner. Lonzo's open, but his shooting just has not developed like everybody thought it would, so he misses another one. And I see Rashawn Holmes, risky pass, but he had good positioning as he was cutting. Rotation of the defense didn't come in time. So that leads me to my sixth assist of the game, and the Lakers cutting into that deficit a little bit now. It is three. The unibrow sets me a high screen, and instead of rolling like he normally does, he pops it from way downtown, and he gets another one to fall. It is unreal, just the shots that he is hitting tonight. Anthony Davis clicking on all cylinders, and you guys will see at halftime just how crazy of a first half he had, but he's not done. One more highlight, why not? Beautiful bounce pass to the cutting AD, and the lead's back up to 6 before the break in action. And great defense closing out the break on LeBron as he tried to get one more basket to fall, but we were all swarming him. And you guys need to see just how crazy of a first half AD has had. 39 points. He's on pace to have a career night despite having some crazy stat lines in his NBA career so far. So here comes the Lakers led by Faron, and immediately coming right out of the gate, JaVale McGee cuts back door and a great court vision from Faron to find him. Still no field goals as a team since coming out of the break, so I try to go to our go-to, a pick and roll between Anthony Davis, but they're really covering it hard. Risky pass to Shaq Harrison, who they left wide open to cut. Just because of the defensive attention we brought on ourselves, Harrison slipped in there and got a bucket. You gotta watch this possession closely. Look at this. One missed shot, a block. Kuzma still stays with it. More great defense, but we just surrender another rebound. That's 4 chances they had. We can't have possessions like that. And I was mad. So immediately I see Rashawn Holmes. I'm like, let me get those 2 points right back. I was so mad when I saw us relinquish 4 shot opportunities on that trip up the court for the Lakers. But here they come again. They're very stout offense. Here comes Faron trying a floater. And I foul him. So look at this. We're up by 4, right? We're up by 4. Faron goes to the free throw line. Shooting about 84% for the career. In his 4th season from Arizona. Gets it to fall. I check out. And the bench lets us down once again. I come back in. We were down 8. Then the lead has now swelled to 12. And our bench unit is really not doing us any favors. Of course, we had a bit of that last year in the playoffs, but unfortunately, it seems to be even amplified now. Look at this right here. Nice job going in there, slipping in, getting an offensive rebound, another possession for my team, and I put it in as well. That's one thing I've noticed a lot. I got in the gym with my ex-roommate, Jaleel Okafor, and he really helped me with our rebounding because I really needed to make that more of a focal point for my game. But real quick, no more talk about my rebounding for a second. We also need to discuss Rui Hachimura. Anthony Davis might be having a career night and everything, but Rui is really leading the way for the Lakers. Second year man out of Gonzaga. Here comes the Pelicans offense, though. I take their big guy one-on-one. I put him on my back hip, and a crafty finish at the rim. I got 16 for me on the game. Of course, you guys know the Lakers are going to try their best to keep their foot on the gas pedal. Up by 10. They're probably trying to close us out as they go to Faron, one of their best scorers. He tries to break me down with the half spin. He stops and pops, but that one will just rim out. Unlucky. Unfortunate. Good looking shot for Faron right there. But immediately we come right back. There's no way Lonzo can even attempt to block that one when I got a 7-foot beast on my team like that going up for lobs. Down by 6, a 3 can cut it in half. And surprisingly, they look for me for that 3. Yes, I get another one to drop in the early goings of year 3. My perimeter shooting is at an all-time high. Lead back to 6. And of course, we got to go back to the man today. He hasn't been very good in the second half. And that's definitely a play that he just has to kick it out on. After marking for 39 points in the first half, the Brow has had a dismal second half. And this culminates into an and-one for JaVale McGee. No Shaq in a full appearance for him in this ballgame. He has been on the mark all night long. He comes up empty from the charity stripe, however, and this is a textbook way to run a fast break. Josh Hart dribbled once when he passed the half-court line, and that was the only dribble we needed to get a layup on that fast break. The lead is to 6. Now here comes LeBron. We've been playing great team defense on him. Once again, JaVale McGee's in there, but can't corral it this time. Pushing it up the floor. Los Angeles knows just how dangerous I can be on the fast break, so they bring a double team, but for some reason leaving Rashawn Holmes completely unattended. Right smack dab in the middle of the paint, and there's assist number 14 on the game for me, and we've made it a 4-point spread now with 2.5 left to go. Aaron Kately with a clutch shot over LeBron. Yes, the rookie gets one to go over the seasoned veteran, making the lead only 2 points now with less than 2 minutes to play. Shot clock winding down on this possession, though. Anthony Davis has to force it up. A terrible shot right there. He had plenty of time to get it out and get a better look to one of his teammates. And that just kind of sums up how his second half has been going. For some reason, Ferran maybe has shut the door on us. That's a big shot for him right there. And now the lead is 5. We have one more opportunity to maybe make some noise with 20 seconds to go. LeBron goes 1-on-1 against Josh Hart right now. And look, for some reason, Lonzo's open. Kaylee closes out, but it's just too late, and the Lakers beat us with the same play that the Hawks beat us with Jrue Holiday on opening night. So, for some reason, man, these stats just do not tell the story. We shot almost 60%, still couldn't get the W. And as you can see, Anthony Davis had 39 in the first half, but only 4 in the second. I had 21 points, 16 assists, only 3 missed shots. Kaylee once again struggling from the floor. Mirotić was solid off the bench. Maybe have to look for him getting more minutes, potentially over Rashawn Holmes, because he's been up and down. Just a lot of inconsistent play so far from almost every aspect of this team. Rui Hachimura had a career night. New career high, 27 points from the second year man out of Gonzaga. LeBron only 26-6, so that's normally be a good stat line for almost anybody else, but not him. And I held Lonzo to only 5 of 15 from the floor. Still can't believe we lost that one, but we're going to have to look forward. And we had a game against Houston, and once again, another near triple-double for me. 23 points, only 1 rebound shy of my first career triple-double, but I'm going to have to wait some more time before I can get that to maybe materialize. And as you guys may see, there is no Rashawn Holmes in the lineup anymore. He broke his nose in this Rockets game, so he's going to be out for the next 4 to 6 weeks, and that's opened up the door for Mirotić to step in. And as you can see, since Nikola Mirotić has stepped into the starting lineup, we've been 3-1 so far. So, maybe that's a trend? Who knows? I mean, it's going to be an interesting lineup having Mirotić at the 4 and Anthony Davis at the 5. And look at the Heat. Speaking of interesting, their lineup is going to be very intriguing this year. They signed Christian Wood in the offseason, and I know you guys saw who was warming up with the ball with the hoodie on. Yeah, they signed Carmelo Anthony as well. And with the acquisition of Christian Wood, that means they're going to slide Brandon Ingram back to his natural 3 position. So, Miami can make some noise definitely this year in the playoffs. It's just crazy how unpredictable year 3 has been so far. So many twists and turns, as there's a nice assist to begin the game against Miami down here in South Beach. As you can see, I'm leading the NBA in assists per game, almost 11 right now for me every night. So, real quick though, it's just crazy how many twists and turns there's been in year 3 so far. It's like Anthony Davis started out really slow. He's starting to kick it into high gear now though. Aaron Kately, boom, he hits a 3 right there. He's been up and down. The emergence of Nikola Mirotić, as you guys have seen, if you guys have been watching closely, his marks in the box score recently have been really good. So maybe Rashawn Holmes getting hurt was a blessing in disguise. Maybe it'll open up the door for Mirotić to really take his game to the next level, because we've been running him at the 4 and Anthony Davis at the 5, and I feel like that's partly the reason why AD is starting to get better with every game that goes by. And here comes Aaron Kately. There's his third field goal of the game already. He had 2 bombs he's hit, and now he hit one, a pull-up J on the fast break. So he's got 8 next to his name already in the first few minutes of this ballgame. But, of course, we got to remember who we're playing. Brandon Ingram in that Ferran trade last year. Ingram and Jimmy Butler down here, such a dynamic 1-2 punch. And with Mirotić in the starting lineup, that seems to be opening up a lot more things for the offense, as you don't see Rashawn Holmes doing stuff like that. Lobbing Josh Hart on a backdoor cut on top of Butler. What a play right there, as Mirotić, he might not have scored a lot this game, but he did a lot of little things that I liked. A lot of things that we thought that Mirotić didn't have to do. We thought Holmes was going to be the one to do the dirty work, but he's just been so inconsistent, we haven't been able to count on him all the time. Anthony Davis just had a circus and one to go. Double team comes this time, and there's my first basket of the game with 3.5 left to go in the first quarter. Miami definitely made some splashes in free agency that could mean they can make some noise in the playoffs. Christian Wood and Carmelo Anthony! But Melo sent back a Bill Russell type block by Anthony Davis, and we run that fast break to perfection. Some early fireworks coming from us in this game against Miami. But it's been very competitive so far. A lot of lead changes. Miami's just 1 point away from tying it up. And I go 1-on-1 against Dragic. The hop step brings the defense in. Josh Hart, does he have a 3-pointer? No, he does not. And If you want to talk about inconsistency, I've discussed Rashawn Holmes. I've brought up Kate Lee, sometimes Anthony Davis. But inconsistency is also one of a staple of Josh Hart's game, unfortunately. So it's just every night you don't know who you can count on with this team, and that seems to be our biggest issue. As here comes Anthony Davis, lockdown defense inside, playing more and more like Bill Russell, which each game that goes on. But as you guys know, we had the lead when I checked out. Nice pass inside to Kaylee as he gets another one to fall for my 7th assist. But we had an early lead in the first quarter, but the bench let us down once again. I came back in and we were down 8 here in the second quarter. Terrible pass by Kendrick Nunn, leading to an open jump shot from me with a step inside the 3-point line. And immediately when I come back onto the court, 8-0 run, just like that. Game is now tied up with only 40 ticks left in the first half. Here comes Shaq Harrison off the bench. He's going to have to step in and play more with the departure of Torrey Craig in free agency over the offseason. And here comes Dragic down the other way. No good. We have one more chance to maybe get a basket here before the break. Built the double team to perfection and give you my 4th field goal of the first half. And we're going to cut this and go to break. No, I'm just kidding. We got one more play to get in here to fit in the first half. I just picked the pocket at Dragic, the seasoned veteran, and I attack. That layup actually gives me a double-double already. I've told you guys a lot about some different characters on this team, but one guy I haven't discussed a lot was Marcos Luzada Silva, the guy who played a few years overseas and then decided to jump into an NBA uniform. There he is. The Brazilian gets that layup to fall. Nice feet for me as they trapped so high up on the perimeter that time. But here comes Christian Wood, pocketing that and one on top of the smaller Shaquille Harrison. And I'll check out for only a few minutes, but just like that, almost the end of the third, and the lead is already up to 15 out of nowhere. Miami scored over 30 points between the time that I left the court and the time I got checked back in. So we're going to need some fireworks if we're going to try to snap this losing streak with me playing the games. Despite being 6-4 in the year so far, I still have not won a game that I've showed you guys that I've jumped in and played. So we're trying to snap that streak right now and improve to 7-4. Tyler Hero open for 3. We catch a break though, still only down by 10. We can still make some noise here at the end of the game. Aaron Kately cutting just like our days back at Texas together. And now the lead was at 8, but they score again. But look at me cutting. Goran Dragic trying to trap Mirotic. Just a bad time to do it as I was wide, wide open. That's going to be the easiest look I might have all season. But Miami just firing on all cylinders ever since I checked out. Now they're already up to 114 points. Nice shot though, off balance. A lot of confidence on that stroke right there. Our opponents right now though are red hot. As you can see in the second half, Miami has only missed 11 field goals compared to 19 made, but I still have Goran Dragic on me, and I just have this feeling that I can get past him. You know, he's lost a few steps in the last few years. A few years into this My League, he's kind of an inferior defender. Look at Mirotic sending that shot back. One guy that we acquired for the bench this year who has not made much of an impact is right there flying through the skies, Glenn Robinson. He's had a lot of struggles early on here in his Pelicans career so far this season. We acquired him to maybe fill in for JJ Redick a little bit as a scorer off the bench, but he just has not been getting it done. But maybe a reverse jam like that off of a missed shot can maybe get him going a little bit. For my 5th rebound of the game, good defense on Kendrick Nunn. I fire another one up. There's Anthony Davis gifting me with my 15th assist of the ball game, and now the lead is only 4. It's back up to 8, however, though. Miami just does not want to miss shots here in the 4th. But look at Josh Hart. Big shot here in the clutch. And once again, another game that we are shooting great from the floor. But our defensive woes have not let us ever take control of this ballgame. It's that and the bench just letting us down once again. But once again, going right at the defense. I beat Kendrick Nunn. I crossed over Olynyk and I had a free lane. So there's 23 for me on the ballgame, accompanied by my 15 assist mark. Here comes another assist on the pick and roll. Trapping so high was the Heat defense, trying to limit what I could do with the ball there, but it just did not come fast enough. Now I try a parallel pick and roll. I love the parallel pick and roll. And look at this. I pass out of my jump shot so Anthony Davis can punch another one down. But we need some stops here. We can't keep trading baskets, and we cut it to 3. But once again, so many closers on this team, and Jimmy Butler would definitely classify as a top closer in the NBA. Once again, we had a chance. We had the opportunity to beat another premier team, but we just came up close. We came up short once again, and it was mostly due to the bench, man. This bench is just not getting it done. Every time I step off the court, I always hold my breath to see what the outcome will be when I check back in, and that was true tonight once again. My 23 points and 18 assists just did not get it done for us tonight once again, and you guys will see in just 1 second the biggest culprit of us, you know, dropping all these games, and it's been the bench points. Look at that, 57 to 24 Miami, completely destroyed in that side of things, and it's crazy. 57 points from a bench unit? Is our second unit really that bad on defense? I mean, come on. We allowed Duncan Robinson 21 points in 16 minutes. I mean, our bench is killing us. And at the end of this episode, let's take a look at all my friends and how they're doing. As you can see, Donovan averaging 11 points only and 13 rebounds. He's the fifth man scoring on that Portland team, which is, you know, says something about how good offensively they are. But we'll see if Donovan continues wants to be in the background instead of a lead scorer. Ferran, second on the Lakers in points per game, similar marks to what he had last year. And Deshaun on the 7-3 Mavericks, averaging 19, new career highs for him in a lot of different categories, including a near triple double against San Antonio. Our upcoming schedule finally eases up a little bit, despite having to take on the West leading Nuggets. It opens up a lot more winnable games coming up, and we're 6-5 right now, just outside of the playoff picture so far, 11 games into the year. And me, I'm leading the NBA in assists per game, and I'm putting up career highs and points per game and about the same steals per game last year. So a lot of ups and downs so far in year three, a lot of information to try to swallow, and but we're gonna have to continue to keep pushing forward, seeing if Mirotić and the starting lineup can continue to produce and help us win games. And we're going to be taking on the Chicago Bulls and former number one overall pick Ja Morant next episode. So a big matchup there, so stay tuned.